आनंदानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वंदे पाप विनाशकं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं आनंदानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वंदे पाप विनाशकं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं नित्यमुक्तं निर्विकल्पं ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकं वंदे शांतमयं बंधं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं नित्यमुक्तं निर्विकल्पं ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकं वंदे शांतमयं।
सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I welcome all the media persons who are here from around the world and all the media, international media persons and devotees, visitors who have gathered around the world in 318 places and 109 cities in 25 countries as on now. We are on live web-based TV and webinar. I'll be taking the questions even from international press through the email or through the webinar. So I welcome all of you with my love and respects. First, I wanted to introduce Professor Dr. Krishna Shyama Rao, MBBS, FRCS, Edlington, BDS, MDS, FDS, RCS, England. This is his qualifications. He is a craniofacial surgeon, a pioneer in treating birth defects in children. He has done over 12,000 surgeries to his credit. University professor in Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences, has guided research projects leading to masters and PhD degrees, honorary advisor to the World Health Organization on its panel on global strategies for prevention of craniofacial anomalies. So I humbly welcome Dr. Krishna Shyama Rao, and I would like to welcome and introduce our advocate, Mr. K.V. Dhananjay. Most of you all know, so you don't need introduction. Mr. K.V. Dhananjay, so can you say a few words about your... No, you need to push the button on.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. My name is K.V. Dhananjay. I'm an advocate. I practice at the Supreme Court and across various high courts. I actually am handling and representing Paramahamsa Nityananda in the courts and at various other tribunals.
I've invited you all to share some of the important scientific studies which we conducted. Recently, we had a 21-day meditation program called Inner Awakening. In that program, The main essence of the program is awakening the Kundalini Shakti, the inner potential bioenergy. In the terms of biology, it can be roughly equated to mitochondria cell energy. We were trying to do some scientific studies, scientific research, how this Kundalini awakening helps human beings, how it can be scientifically measured. So we have done a study with an independent research team, independent researchers. They have come up with astounding results. After the thorough double-blinded study, they are saying this Kundalini awakening process, usually in the colloquial terms you can use many words like a spiritual healing, spiritual touch, or initiation, Shakti path. There are so many words we have. Of course, the chart sheet says hypnotizing and mind control. In an abusive way, you can use any bad words. In a positive way, the right words. And I wanted to study how it really helps people. It's an age-old tradition, an enlightened master touching somebody and healing that person, the spiritual healing, the Kundalini awakening, or the energy transmission. These are all different words for the same phenomena. We wanted to study the science of this phenomena, the scientific aspect of this phenomena. So we invited group of researchers, the scientific researchers, and they have come and did a double-blind study. All the samples were collected before the program, and 18th day of the program, they have done thorough study of height, weight, the physical changes, mental changes, and the final blood test. Finally, they are proving, because of this Kundalini awakening, the mitochondria cell energy, which can never be increased by any known method, like a medicines or therapies or yoga, any known method, exercise or anything, can improve that cell energy only 25 to 30%. But that cell energy has been increased by this Kundalini awakening process 1300%, means 13 times. So they say, the scientists are saying, it is directly anti-aging, means reversal of the aging process. Many ways, physically, mentally, physiologically, people are getting benefited. So they have done a thorough study, and we may take a few minutes to listen to Dr. Krishna Rao to get the complete understanding about the medical research and study they have done. Then I'll answer all the questions you have. If you want to give it in writing, you can give in writing. Or if you want to ask directly, you can ask. I'll answer. Please understand, it's my humble request. I'll be here till the last question is answered. So I only request, ask one by one. Ask one by one. I'll have the patience to answer. If you are really interested in honest answers, in truth, I'll sit here. I'm available. I've decided to speak out. I wanted to tell you all, actually, I am not the person avoid speaking. In last 8 years of my public life, I have spoken 9,000 hours. I have a video record of 9,000 hours of my talk. So I am not the person who will avoid speaking. I avoided speaking because of lawyers, legal advice. They all said, Swamiji, the case will be quashed. Then you can start talking. That's the only reason I waited. Now I feel it is time I should open up and I should talk. I am going to be here answering all your questions. My only request, please ask one by one. If you all ask too many questions at a time, and I am already informed there are one or two miscreants have been sent inside in the name of press. So I do not want them to destroy the whole show. Please understand, there are 99% of the people, responsible media. I don't want that one or two miscreants steal the show or disturb the show. So each one of you ask individually. I'll answer all the questions. I'm going to be here. I'll answer all the questions. So I'll now request Dr. Krishna Shyamara to present his study, his discoveries, which he calls earth-shattering, groundbreaking. No known allopathy, medicine, or science, or exercise, or yoga can increase this mitochondria cell energy more than 25 to 30%. But this Kundalini awakening, the spiritual touch, spiritual healing, has awakened that energy to 1300%, 13 times more. That's the essence. I request Dr. to carry on.
Good afternoon. This is the first time I am addressing a live TV audience. I speak often in medical audiences in front of my peers. So I'll try to make the subject as simple as possible. I hope you can hear me clearly. The study we did was basically studying physical, which is height, weight, calculating the body mass index, and chest measurement, waist measurement, and so on. We also measured physiological parameters like blood pressure, heart rate, blood glucose levels, and so on. And we did a very unusual study which actually measures the mitochondria activity of the cell, which is called the MTT assay. Now, all the samples that were collected were sent to a professional laboratory, and they were actually assayed in that particular lab. The principal investigators are myself, my name you can see on the top, and my co-investigator is Professor Smita Hegde from the Mangalore University Department of Biotechnology. Let me give you a little understanding of what a mitochondria is. I mean, it's a very strange word, and unless you are a medical person, or you have done biology very recently, you may not understand it. In a simple term, if you think of a battery, a mitochondria is a battery of the cell. Now, unlike torch that you hold, where you might have two batteries or three cells, in the human being, each cell has between 1,000 to 100,000 small batteries, and these are called mitochondria. This is the specialty of being a human being. The intelligence of our cell is so high that it cannot rely on a single battery. So it has created small number of many batteries. So even if one or two were to fail, the rest would continue to keep you alive. So this is what it looks like in a colorful diagram. Now understand that every living cell in our body has a complete mechanism on its own. It's intelligent by itself. There are many cells which live alone in the world. We call bacteria and viruses and so on. And our human body is made of 50 trillion cells, not million, not billion, trillion cells. And all of them work together like a family in unison. But they have specialized jobs. Though they have specialized jobs, see, some cells might be producing insulin, some cells might be muscle, some cells might be from the brain, but they all have some common features. And amongst the common feature is that they all carry the battery called the mitochondria. So the mitochondria is the battery of the cell present in every living cell. If the battery goes, the cell goes. Now, the very peculiar thing about this mitochondria is, I don't know if you have heard of DNA. It's a very common word nowadays. DNA is your blueprint of whatever you are, whether you're an animal or a man or whatever. And the mitochondria has come with its own DNA. Unlike the rest of the cell, which depends on the DNA from the nucleus, the mitochondria is unique that it has its own DNA. Now that gives it special properties. First of all, the primary job is to run the cell like a battery, so it gives energy. Now, for example, if you didn't have mitochondria, every glucose molecule that you ate would produce only two molecules of energy, two ATPs, two molecules of energy. It's like a very poorly charged battery. But if you have mitochondria which is functioning properly, every molecule of glucose produces 32 ATPs. That's almost like a 1,700% increase in energy simply by the activity that the battery does. It increases and makes it more efficient in the production of energy. Let's talk about the DNA of the mitochondria. The DNA is the structure which can create the mitochondria, which can repair the mitochondria when it gets damaged. But unlike inside the nucleus, the DNA of the mitochondria is exposed. It's naked. It doesn't have a protective covering. And because it doesn't have a protective covering, it gets damaged very quickly. The slightest error in its manufacturing energy can damage the mitochondria and the DNA very quickly. And when the DNA is damaged, you start to age and you become old. So a damaged mitochondria produces something called reactive oxygen species. Basically what it means is it produces energy minus one electron, and that minus electron actually destroys whatever it comes in touch with, because it tries to steal the electron from the other components. So the mitochondria, which functions beautifully, will keep you alive and well for a very long time. A mitochondria which is damaged and not working efficiently quickly ages you, and you have a premature death. So the study we did was a program called the Inner Awakening, which was conducted here from the 1st of December to the 21st of December 2010. There were 134 participants from all over the world. We took the following physical parameters like height, weight, calculated the BMI. We took the chest waist measurement and again calculated the chest waist ratio. We took fasting blood sugar in diabetics and kept measuring it intermittently. We also studied their blood pressure, systolic and diastolic, in the beginning, in the middle, and at the end, just to see what happens. Now, this is the interesting part. We took 10 samples of participants who were actually above 50 years of age randomly, as well as 10 control samples, and we just labeled them with numbers and then quickly sent it off to the laboratory in the University of Mangalore. The testing was done at the Postgraduate Institute of Biotechnology, St. Aloysius College, Mangalore University. The test is called MTT assay. After we got all the data together, we sent it to a professional statistician who was employed by the animal nutrition department, and he did the statistics for us. A simple graph for you to show that over 18 days, the fasting sugar in diabetics came down to a proportion that was considered as statistically very significant. Now, there was no diet control imposed in the program at all, and all the participants had normal ashram food, which basically is vegetarian and largely carbohydrate driven. Now here comes the unusual thing. This is a chart that compares the weight loss during 21 days and the loss in inches around the chest and waist. Now unusually, you would not expect this to happen. Normally when somebody loses weight, they lose weight everywhere. And that is normal. In this instance, participants lost up to 5 inches around their waist for a mere weight loss of about 1.5 kilos or 1 kilo, 1.5 kilos, maybe maximum 2 kilos. Now, loss of inches around the waist in medical parlance means you have lost the fat that surrounds your visceral organs, like liver, like your spleen, like your stomach. And this is the fat that causes heart attacks. This is the fat that causes high blood pressure. This is the fat that causes diabetes. And this is the fat that is the dangerous fat. The fat under your skin is not very dangerous. The fat inside your body, around your organ, is very dangerous, called visceral fat. And one of the measurements is, if you dramatically lose inches around your waist without having too much weight loss overall, it's a very significant finding. Now we come to the main thing. This is the MTT assay showing you the mitochondria levels in the control and the study group in the beginning at day zero, which you can see so low. And on day 18, it significantly went up to the extent of 1,300%, that is 13 times increase. Now, this is a very unusual figure. The reason being, normally, even if you were to exercise or do some yoga, the mitochondria in your muscle might increase to some extent. But the cells that we studied were blood cells. They were not muscle cells. We studied the white blood cells, and the mitochondria in the white blood cell, for it to increase so dramatically, is very unusual. And that too without any medical intervention. It's extremely unusual. So this is a very significant finding in medical terms. Now, when a statistician measures things, he gives it a p-value. And a p-value of less than 0.001 is considered highly significant. In statistics, there is no higher word than this. So I cannot say superbly significant or absolutely fantastically significant, because statistically, that is the last word. But the values are much more than the word highly significant, as you can see. We also conducted a questionnaire, which was conducted by another co-investigator, and who has a PhD in this area. And we studied various improvements that the patients or the participants reported in the 18-day period. And there was phenomenal changes, especially in those who had evidence of depression, insomnia, anxiety, panic disorders, and so on. In fact, even rare conditions like fibromyalgia, that is the first bar you can see, which is a very difficult condition to treat medically. We had only one participant who had this condition, but this one participant went back 100% cured. We need to investigate further to see what are the other changes that have taken place in our autoimmune system to bring about this change. But certainly this one participant recovered completely during the 18-day process. We also have data on various other factors like heightened wakefulness, sleep wakefulness, which means you sleep well, but you are still aware of what's happening. Now these are all very significant subjective findings, which I think will go a long way in the future once we have very large data bank to show you what the various processes of the inner awakening actually does physiologically. So just to summarize briefly, the mitochondria is a battery of the cell, and it determines the activity of the cell, the lifespan of the cell, and also the viability of each cell. A phenomenal increase in mitochondrial activity, 1,300 times, is extremely unusual and suggests a tremendous re-energization of the cell. The cells that we studied were white blood cells, not skeletal muscle, so even exercise need not have made any difference to it. Normally, one would expect increase in mitochondrial activity after yoga or exercise in muscle cells only. So this suggested to us that a phenomenon other than exercise and yoga or even diet is responsible for this surge of mitochondrial activity. Now, what I would like to call this phenomenon, I don't know at this moment from the medical point of view. But it is a phenomenon that is not physical. that much we can tell right now. In any case, the benefits of this program across the board have been great. Blood pressure has been reduced, diabetes has been reduced, and so many other physical and physiological benefits have come to the patients. So we are now planning to do a very large scale study, not only of the mitochondria, but also of the DNA of the individual cells and the participants. And this would allow us to actually study, you know, mutations that take place in the DNA. Can the mutations be completely eliminated during the process and so on. The next program that would be studied would be in the month of March, and a very detailed large scale analysis is being planned for the same. Thank you very much. This in brief is my presentation.
I wanted to share a few words. As I'm now, in 121 cities, in 26 countries, 419 places, people are sitting with us live. I welcome all the newcomers also who logged in. And please continue to send your questions through email. At the end of answering all the live questions, I'll answer your questions also. You may ask, why suddenly I decided to do this scientific research? I'm really shocked and surprised. People are responsible for slapping a rape charge on me. No, it's almost like a slapping a 200 rupee theft case on a president or prime minister or state of some head. How silly it is. No, really. See, still I am living with hundreds of women. I am the head of a spiritual institution which has 1 crore followers around the world. And these guys have no sense to. Don't they feel ashamed to slap a rape charge on me? And I am surprised. I read the charge sheet, and it is saying that 4 years, in 2005, somebody has been raped. Police should have had at least asked that so-called false victim. They should have asked, if you are being raped, why do you go to his room again and again for 4 years? Such a simple question. Now, such a simple question, why do you go to his room again and again for 4 years if you are being raped? Such a simple, innocent question is enough. Of course, they bring a term, mind control, or being mesmerized. I am really wondering, can anybody, and of course, still we are not able to identify who the person is in the whole India, 2.5 lakh cases, you did the research? 2.5 lakh cases, he has done research. There is no 376 charge slapped on anybody without a name in FIR. First time in India, the FIR on me, 376 rape charge is slapped without any victim. Who has been raped? Nobody knows. And then they are trying to discover victims. In the court, COD is saying, first they said Ranjita is a victim. When they are not able to convince her to be a victim, I am live, so I am understanding what I am talking. When they are not able to convince her to be a victim, then they change the name to Gopika. When they are not able to find that person also, then suddenly some new person has come back. Still, we don't know the name. And the same way, first time in Indian history, some charge sheet has been filed without the name of a victim. What is going on? Is this country ruled by the constitution and law? I am really shocked and surprised. I was just keeping quiet politely for so many reasons, because if I open my mouth, the persecution on me and my organization will increase. I am threatened, blackmailed by powerful people. Please understand. Of course, now I have a complete list with evidences and everything. I will present the whole story. I'm before presenting the whole story, I'll just share these few things. why I did this research. I saw that they are talking about the new term called mind control, the sacred Hindu tradition of spiritual initiation and the Kundalini awakening is being derogatorily abused, slandered in the name of mind control and hypnotism. This is too much. This is too much. That's the reason I decided to call the scientists to study the whole process. I invited them, come on, I opened my doors to them. And this 21-day workshop from all over the world, from 40 countries, 134 people were attending. I invited the scientists, please come and study and tell me what it is. Is it a hypnotism or mesmerism? What it is? This is the scientific report. They say the Kundalini awakening, the spiritual touch or the spiritual healing, the initiation, energy transmission, whatever name you can use, is doing physical, physiological, mental good to people and reversing the aging process, increasing the mitochondria cell energy 1300%, 13 times, which can be done any other ordinary medicines or yoga or exercise, anything can increase this mitochondria energy only 25 to 30%. Here 1300%, it has been increased, it has happened. So this is the final report of the scientists. I respectfully invite COD police officials, if they are interested in honest investigation, come and attend the program. Come and attend the program and bring your women staff also. Let them attend the program and find out for yourself, is it mind controlling, hypnotism or mesmerism, or doing physical and mental and physiological good to people? See, me being abused, I tolerate it. After all, we are in the same world, you abusing me or I answering you back, it's a lifestyle, okay. That's okay. But abusing the age-old Hindu tradition, abusing 10,000 years of Vedic tradition, I invite all the Hindu groups in the India, in the world, understand your tradition is being abused. The tradition in which are we standing, it is being abused. I invite all of you to look in. Here I am trying to record, prove, protect, validate the Hindu spiritual Vedic tradition scientifically, and these guys are abusing it in the name of mesmerism, hypnotism, all kinds of mind control words. It is not mind control, it is not mesmerism, it is not hypnotism, it is pure spirituality. I am really shocked that they will go to the extreme and extent of saying mind control. I am really not able to understand. How can somebody's mind be controlled for 4 years? What is going on? Is there no logic? Is there no simple sense? I am really shocked and surprised seeing that. See, I know they arrested me illegally, unlawfully, without having any victim. So now they have to justify that arrest. So what to do? All right, at least understand now. And even till I got the bail and came out, there was no victim. I was arrested without any victim, and I came out of the bail without any victim. And this all right, something has happened in that heat, in that fervor, because the whole society was against me. They have to, police has to follow the public opinion. They have done something. At least now it is time to understand and accept that they try to go on justify, and the persecution is continuing. I will now give you the list one by one. After I finish talking, I will take your questions. I will first finish talking. No, I wanted to present all the facts. Don't clap. All right, it's not even my disciples, it's a public also. Ah, yes. I say all our disciples, please don't clap, just be silent. But public, I don't know how to control. I think public are also inside. All right. Can you? All right. Wait, volunteers. If there is a public, anybody is clapping, please send them out. And our disciples, please don't clap. I request you to maintain the silence and dignity and respect the press. Yes. Here, I'll just finish a few of these things. March 3rd, 2010, after that marked video has been released, the attempts to burn the ashram property in the wake of incident, three brahmacharis were locked inside the hut where they were staying and they were about to be burned. The fire was put, but our brahmacharis saved them and got them out. Still, there is no FIR or any action done on the people who have done this illegal, atrocious act. See, first thing I want to know, even the allegation is on me. Whether it is, if it is moral, I'll face in front of my devotees. If it is legal, I'll face in front of the court. That is over. That's all. Why should my ashrams be burnt all over the world? Sorry, not all over the world. Only in Tamil Nadu. Only in Tamil Nadu. In Karnataka, even after the incident, we recorded and saw the video. It is not from Karnataka people. No Karnataka people, no local person has ever harmed me. I offer my humble gratitude to all the people who live in Karnataka and people who live all around this area, surroundings. They were so humble and respectful. Still, I go for evening walk and their love and respect for me is unimaginable. I humbly offer my gratitude to all the people who reside in this local village and Karnataka area for their love, respect, friendliness, care, concern, devotion they show towards me. It is, of course, as you all may be aware, or if you are not aware, now I wanted to make you aware, this morphed, misrepresented, manipulated video was used to blackmail me, some of the powerful persons. I can say, representatives have claimed they are representing those powerful persons. I do not have evidence that these people who blackmailed me are directly representing the people whom they claim, but I have evidence for these people coming and blackmailing me. At least 100 crores was demanded. Then the bargaining, they have reduced the price to 60 crore. Then different cost and different time, different way. And at least two representing those few people, few powerful people. And one more thing I want to tell you, I have revealed this information to COD. They only were able to sympathize with me. And they said, just relax, Swamiji. And they sympathized with me and nothing else has happened. Nothing else could be done. I have revealed all this information to COD and nothing happened. They sympathized with me. They just sympathized. Anyhow, then after the blackmailing, I said very clearly, I am not interested in spending a single penny. I am not going to give a single penny. But even after that, some of our devotees have been blackmailed. And they took money from the devotees, saying, we will harass your Swami and all that without my knowledge. Some money, how much, still I don't know. I am collecting the evidence. I will present everything in the court. In the court, everything will be presented. Some money was taken very solidly. That much we know. And after that, they released this so-called morphed video all over the world. And some of the surprising things I wanted to reveal to you is that the March 3rd to 10, the defamatory videos continue on the TV and internet. Thousands of video chips was loaded, thousands through thousands of PCs, personal computers, within 24 hours. It means a huge organized setup. at least through 1700 PCs, personal computers, it has been loaded to the cyberspace. Can understand the amount of people. I can say at least few companies were full-time involved in uploading this video on the internet, and 1.5 lakh tweets have been generated within 24 hours in the net. And as you all know, in the whole history of the internet, only 2 times internet jamming has happened. One, Michael Jackson's death, another one, this scandal video. And I wanted all of you to know, I think I said this last time itself, Michael Jackson, poor guy, 50 years, he has to sing, jump, dance, country to country, city to city, finally he has to die to jam the internet. I did not do anything. And somebody did something, internet was jammed. Okay. And the next thing, the multiple cases filed in Tamil Nadu, everywhere. And I can say this is one of the legal wonder. Wonder is a good word. I should not use the word. But all right. 376. Rape charge with no victim. First time in India. No victim's name is mentioned. The rape charge has been slapped. And cheating with no evidence. 295A. Hurting religious sentiments. Actually, these guys who created this video, presented to the world, have heard the religious sentiments of 1 crore my disciples around the world, who belong to 13 religion, 197 countries, who are running 1,200 worship places all over the world. And I have been slapped with the hurting the religious sentiments. The funny things, the most funny things. And I challenge all the legal intellectuals. This is the wonder. Unprecedented. Anyhow, the criminal intimidation, a blatant lie with no evidence presented in the court, that was also slapped on me. And desperate attempt to transfer the case to CBI, magnifying the situation, was tried, but the court, the request was dismissed outright by the court. And another one thing, anyhow, all these things happened. I was at that time in Kumbh Mela. Then, please understand, my secretary, Sri Nitya Satchidananda Swami, has very clearly informed COD officials, sir, whenever you want Swamiji for interrogation, please inform us and our lawyer. Within 24 hours, Swamiji will be available for interrogation. He has been clearly there been told. And after that also, I was in Himachal Pradesh, because of too much of threat. People who come here to burn the huts, they left petrol bombs and acid bottles. And too much of threat from all corners. In the name of media, people come and try to hurt. You see, it's like we do not know what is happening, who is attacking from what corners. So this was the situation. And even while I was sitting in Himachal, I was continuously giving press meets. I was at least in that span, after the scandal video broke out, until I was arrested, at least to 50 to 100 press I have met. We have enough record and reports. I have met at least 50 to 100 press. And I was meeting the press. And it's not that Himachal Pradesh, I was hiding in some place. Every day I was going for a walk and meeting people, blessing them, giving them autographs, talking to them, healing them. I was out in public every day. I used to walk at least 8 kilometers. Evening 8 kilometers I'll walk into the city. I'll go to a market, talk to people, bless them. My usual walk I was doing. And police, when they traced where I am staying, without giving any time, 2 notices summoning me to come for interrogation were stuck on my quarters. 1 notice was past due date. Time is over. The second notice was posted night 9:30 asking me to come for interrogation for 7 o'clock. Two notice. And then, of course, this was the two notice. We have evidence for everything. And fortunately, our brahmacharis have captured almost whatever I am talking through cell phone camera or through video camera. We have evidence for all these things. Then, I was waiting for anticipatory bail. All our lawyers also said, Swamiji, there is no victim. So there is nobody is complaining. Naturally, they will not arrest you. So we can get an anticipatory bail and come. And that's all. Nothing else needs to be done. It's a simple thing. And because of the legal advice, I was waiting for anticipatory bail. And another one thing, just before the bail was granted, few hours before, police has lied to the court about the time of the arrest. We have evidence. They arrested me after 3 o'clock, but they lied to the court by 11. The moment they traced the time of where I am staying, immediately informed the court and made the anticipatory bail petition infructuous. And whatever I am talking, I have evidence for everything. And anyhow, finally they try to take confession or so-called confession in the police custody, held in police custody, interrogated heavily from 21 to 30, and then May, June to 12, judicial custody. Of course, fortunately for me, unfortunately for them, they were not able to get a single victim. And first time in India, usually when complaints come, they catch accused. Here they are saying, in all TVs and newspapers, advertisement was given. If you have complaints against Nityananda, please come and give. They are saying, here we have accused, we don't have victim, please come on. What is happening? First time in Indian history, have you heard anywhere saying that in the media, here we have accused, please come on, we need victims. In all channels of South India, major channels at least, the advertisements were given, scrollings were sent, news was read. If you have complaints against Nityananda, please come, please come, please come, keeping me in prison. Nobody complained, of course. Nobody has suffered. That is one thing. And then CID conducted raids on the ashram, confiscated 22 computers of web and publication department, where we are teaching, where we are publishing books on Bhagavad Gita and Yoga Sutra, spirituality, reducing the crime rate of the world, continuously working and teaching meditation. I want all of you to know, Still, I am one of the largest watched gurus in the YouTube, not just on Hinduism. See, in YouTube, 40 gurus have been named as the topmost watched gurus. And in the 40, I am one of the leading. And of course, many others follow Ramdev Baba, and many other gurus are following. Still, I am one of the most watched guru in the YouTube, thousands of hours of discourse. And still, I'm one of the largest Hindu publication. Published 500 volumes in 26 languages. All over the world, we are circulating our spiritual literature. These departments, publication departments, and web departments, hard disks have been raided and confiscated by the CID. Later, reports have appeared in the press. We don't know whether CID gave the information or some press wrote by themselves. We do not know that, so I cannot say. But the press reports have appeared. Many videos of Nityananda with women and porn material was found in the hard disk. But in the court, nothing was submitted. The court did not tell anything like that. That's the first thing. Second thing, when the court has given the hard disk back to us, 22 hard disks, none of them are in working condition. We are not able to prove it's a lie. There was no porn material. It was completely spiritual, yoga, meditation related materials. And these guys, I don't know now who is responsible for spreading all these lies. And High Court of Tamil Nadu issued a strong 60-page stay order to Tamil magazine Nakiran against publishing defamatory articles on me. But still, even after that, they continued, and the contempt of court case is in pending. On the basis of one letter from the police, please understand, this is another one wonder. First time In India, the officials are so fast in working. One letter goes from police to the passport authorities. Within 24 hours, my passport was illegally impounded. And still my passport is being held by COD illegally. Please understand, passport can be impounded only if the court convicts. No court has convicted me. But just the one police officer is writing within 24 hours. And I'm surprised how the government offices in India started working in 24 hours. And such major decisions are made and impounding happens. Impounding a passport of a man who is traveling almost 100,000 miles a year. And for no reason, completely illegal. And still they are holding the passport. It is sitting there. Anyhow, I do not know, still holding a passport is legal or illegal? Okay. All right. All bank accounts of various trusts of the ashram were frozen by police illegally, so that I cannot have good legal help. That was one main reason why we suffered so much in the initial level without having large, solid legal help and legal support. Suddenly all the bank accounts were frozen. Why should they freeze a public charitable trust bank account when there is no economical offense complaints have come to them? And again, it's illegal. Of course, fortunately, the High Court of Karnataka lifted the bank account freeze on June 18th. No arguments since the police withdrew the illegal freeze. And May 16th, CID interrogating me. The video was publicly released of Nityananda's police interrogation, leaked to internet and to media and flashed on TV, which is a complete breach of security and privacy and illegal. Just to hurt the religious sentiments of my disciples, 1 crore disciples around the world. I want all of you to know, devotees, disciples, followers, all put together, 1 crore people are there around the world in 197 countries who are following me, my teachings or my whatever I am standing for, and 1,200 full-timers who are living and breathing my teachings as life and spreading that as a life. And just to hurt their religious sentiments, this video has been released, leaked. I do not know whether it is purposefully happened or without their control it happened. I am really surprised. A COD, a police department inside their office where supposed to be a tight security. How can from there something leak to internet? Are you able to believe? Or I wanted to ask press, are you able to believe? I don't know. Anyhow. And the next thing, November 29th, case for quashing the proceeding against Nityananda was listed for final disposal in High Court. After giving over 8 months' time to CID for investigation, and our lawyers are sure our petition will be allowed and the case will be quashed because it is baseless. But after High Court of Karnataka gave multiple raps to CID for not being able to substantiate the case, November 27, suddenly charge sheet was filed as last minute effort by CID to save their face with the clause that says investigation is still not complete. If your investigation is not complete, why are you filing charge sheet? Just with one aim, ensure the case is not quashed so that the 482 petition becomes infructuous. That is the, otherwise there is no urgency in filing a charge sheet. Last moment, please understand, using all techniques, is it legal techniques or illegal techniques?
Everything is illegal.
Illegal techniques, I am being harassed. The religious persecution is continuing. See, I am planning to have a program from March 2nd to March 23rd, all over the world, all the persecuted religious leaders are gathering. Actually, we have done the pilot program January 29. We expected in 108 places all over the world, people will gather and meditate, pray for the peace and stopping the religious persecutions. Please understand, in many Islamic countries, the minor sects of Islam group itself, minor sects are persecuted. Same way, in many kind of expression, I am gathering all the intellectuals all over the world. And January 19th, we planned to hold this peace meditation in 108 places, but we are successful in holding 617 places, 236 cities in 26 countries. Now, we are again going to do this for 21 days, and not only that, from all over the world, rationalists, intellectuals, scientists who are working on the spirituality, spiritual people who are working with the scientists, all of them are sending their support letter with their blood thumb impression and blood signature. Already it has started pouring. Please understand, I am not collecting this blood thumb impression, blood signature from ordinary villagers or on the roadside. This is all highly intellectuals, doctors, PhDs, Nobel laureates, including Nobel laureates, are sending their blood thumb impression, supporting me to stop this religious persecution continuously happening on me. All this will be handed over end of this 21-day global peace process. 21 day we are going to do this global peace gathering all over the world. First thing, to request all governments to stop these religious persecutions. Allow the religious expression and freedom. Stop these illegal persecutions. And second thing, to create the global peace, meditating. The end of this 21-day session, we already started receiving this blood sign letters, blood thumb impression letters. Thousands have already poured in. And by the end, we are expecting almost 1 lakh letters we'll be having from around the world. All intelligent community, intellectuals, educated and press people, all rationalist people from different ideology. I'll be presenting this 1 lakh letter copy to the Prime Minister of India, President of India, Chief Minister of Karnataka, Governor of Karnataka, Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Governor of Tamil Nadu. I will be presenting to all of them. Even after that, if this illegal religious persecution on me and my disciples, another one thing, in the Bangalore Press Club, there was a press meet. Few of my disciples went. I don't even know. I was sitting here and taking class. I was continuing my sessions. Not only I did not go, I don't even know who went. You see, thousands of people are living all over the world. I do not know all the thousands of people are doing, what they are doing whole day. Few people went. Not only they did not do anything, they just went an observer, onlooker. False cases are filed on them. False cases were slapped on me also. FIR was slapped on me also. But fortunately, we had the whole thing video recorded. When we requested the High Court, in the 482 petition, High Court has stayed the proceeding. It is continuing. You see, actually, if they stopped the persecution, along with when the heat happens and the chaos happens, naturally, police extremism or one or two steps they want to take just to show the world. If they would have stopped with that, I would also keep quiet. But it's not stopping. The atrocity and the persecution is not stopping. It is continuing. If I keep quiet, it almost like justifies what they are doing is right. That is the reason I need to come out open to the press and share my concerns and my side of the story. I'll finish it and then take the questions. And I'll answer all your questions. And I only request if you... Okay, you need to leave, all right. And let me finish this. We are getting support from all over the world, and these letters will be public, you will be giving, and already the supports have come from the groups of the Chinese literary critic and writer Professor Lau Xiaobo. All right, Nelson Mandela and the Nobel Peace Prize winner of 1993, and Aung San Suu Kyi, a Burmese opposition politician. Many of these groups are extending their support, and I am receiving many supporting letters from all over the world, from many persecuted religious leaders and political leaders, for no reason, illegally being harassed. And here I am requesting all the Hindu groups in India to understand what I am contributing to the world and society, and stand up and bring all these things to the attention of the government. For no reason, me and my people are being persecuted, harassed. And even just few days before, January 12th and 29th, summons are issued by CID illegally. Am I right?
Everything is illegal.
Illegally. Even after the charge sheet is already filed, illegally someone was filed, sent. We give a proper respectful response in writing. In writing we gave the response, as this is illegal, unconstitutional, please understand this summon is answered, we submitted in writing as per the legal advice. After that, that officer has an audacity to call my representative and tell, this guy is a is this country is being ruled by constitution and law, or just some sadist people? I'm really shocked. Are we here? What do they mean by the religious freedom or ruled by country with the constitution and law and order? And I do not know if after sending this 100,000 letters, blood signed letters to the all the rulers of the country, if the religious persecution continues, I have no other way except doing a padayatra from Kanyakumari to Bidri. From Kanyakumari to Bidri, sorry, Bidar. Bidar is the end of the Karnataka.
Yes.
Bidar. In two states, I am planning to do padayatra with court's permission. Once I get the court's appropriate permission, I will do padayatra, and that is the. At least I will have to go to people and ask for justice. See, in 120 places, only in Tamil Nadu, worship centers, worship altars, my temples, ashrams, satsang centers are being beaten, broken and burnt. Not a single FOR is filed. Not a single FOR is filed. In 17 places, my brahmacharinis and sannyasinis have been abused physically. Saris are being pulled. Physically they have been abused. And 7 places, my brahmacharis have been attacked with a motive to kill. With a motive to kill. Whatever I am uttering, we have evidences. Whatever I am saying, we have evidences. And still it is continuing. Still it is continuing. And who can put full stop to it? Only you all can. Media can do solution.